Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and today we are going to talk about how to create this bouncing car animation in PowerPoint. And this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Camp Keyframe, and he created that animation in After Effects, and I tried my best to replicate the same in PowerPoint. So take a look at the animation that he created in After Effects, and he has also given the link of the project file, After Effects project file, in the description of his video, and I have given the link of all the files and the original video in the description of my video, and you can easily download that project file from Google Drive. Here is that file. And we would also like to thank Renanta Pienka at Patreon. He is supporting us. So let's get started with the animation. So after downloading the file, After Effect file, project file, so when you will open that file in After Effect, you will see all the composition that he used to create this entire animated scene, a 6 second long scene. And here you can see all the layers that he has used. Unfortunately, he doesn't provide the Adobe Illustrator file. So what we have to do that we need to export all this layer to Photoshop and then transfer them to PNG transparent files. So here you can see all the layers that I exported as separate PNG file, then I combined them into PowerPoint. However, you can also use the shape tool from the insert tab. Here is the shape tools, and if you insert any of the shape and select it, then you get the shape format tab on top. And under the shape format, you can use all these tools to create these kinds of graphics. However, for this particular video, I am using a separate method. Instead of drawing the entire scene and character for myself, I am going to export all these layers to Photoshop, and then we will export them from the Photoshop to each object into a different transparent layer, as you can see here. So I am not good with After Effects. So still I will try to explain that how I did this. So for that you need to go to the composition tab, and here you need to click on save frame as and then choose Photoshop layers. And here I would like to create a new folder and name it AE2 Photoshop, let's say, and then I will click on save. Here you can see the save as type is Photoshop. Now if I go to that folder, AE2 Photoshop, here you can see that file that I exported, Adobe Photoshop image. So now what I will do, I will move to Photoshop and will open the same file here. And here you can see all the layers. However, you can delete those layers that you don't want, like this car null. And then here we have further layers with the null. We don't require this one. However, you can export all of these and later you can delete which you don't require. So I will select all these layers by holding the shift key and then selecting the first one and then the last one. So to export all of these layers into a separate transparent file, I will go to layers, export as, and here you will see all the layers, and you can see that the null layers doesn't have any picture here because these are After Effects objects. So now what I will do, I will click on export all, and here is asking for the folder name where you want to export it. So I will export into the same folder, AE2 Photoshop, and then click select folder. And if now we move to that folder, then you can see here all the layers as a separate PNG files. All these files are transparent, and later we will import these layers into the PowerPoint. And for that you can go to PowerPoint and then press Ctrl N to open a new presentation, change the layout to blank, and if here I go to insert picture from this device, then go to the desktop, AE2 Photoshop, and here you can see all the layers. And if I choose this one, let's say, then you can later change the size as you require. And One more thing I would like to tell that you can, if I switch back to the original folder where I have placed all these files. So here we have the entire car, and I am going to copy and paste that into PowerPoint. So in PowerPoint, when you need to combine all these layers, let me send it to back. So what you can do, you can place these layers on top of the full picture and then can adjust the size easily. And you can also see in the background the original layer. That is the good thing about PowerPoint, that when you resize the pictures, transparent pictures, then you can also see the background picture as well during the resize. So that way I have combined all these layers and created this entire scene, and making the animation of this entire scene is very easy, because what we did, we are not using any animation effect. If I open the animation pan by clicking on the animations tab and then click animation pan, then you can see that I have not used a single animation effect in PowerPoint. That is the audio file that we are using in the for the background sound. And further, if I move to the next slides, then you can see in the animation pan, nor we are using any transition on any of the slide, not even the morph transition, because that morph transition is not available in all the PowerPoint versions. So I tried to create this animation so you can make these kind of animation even in earlier versions of PowerPoint, like PowerPoint 2007 as well. So what is the trick that I am using to create this animation is, I am just replicating all of these slides and changing the position. So before that, I would also like to tell you about the selection pen, which is necessary to handle. If you don't know how to use the selection pen, then you must watch my video on how to use selection pen. And here you can click on the select drop down button and choose selection pen. And here I have named all the layers as per the requirement. And if you see the original PNG exported files, then you can notice that the original animator camp keyframe created all those objects in separate layer. So same way I imported all the layers into PowerPoint and named them separately. That is because you need to separate those layers in primary layers that you want to animate. So in our case, we approximately need all of the layers as separate primary layers. So that is why I created them here. And you must have a good knowledge of using selection pen when you want to create these kinds of complicated animations in PowerPoint. So once you have placed all the layers and designed the first scene of your animation, then what you can do, you can right click on it and then choose duplicate slide. And here we need to change the position, and that is the tricky part. And one more thing I would like to tell you, that we are not going to use the background layer. And instead of that, we have filled the background with the color, with the same color. If I right click on this and choose format background, then here you can see I have used the solid fill with the same color, this one, and applied this color to all of the slides. And for that, you can click on this apply to all button. That is because if you will insert a picture in the background, like this one, and send it to the back. So using a picture for the background is not a good idea, because when you need to adjust the position of these layers, you will by mistake will always select the background picture as well. So instead of placing a picture in the background, you can place a fill color instead, or you can hide that particular layer if you don't want it for the time. And later when all is done, then you can later turn it back on. So I don't want it, so I will delete this layer. So how I change the position of these layers, that is the important thing to learn in this animation. And that is why I was telling you that you must have a good understanding of selection pan. So on the next slide, let's say I want to change the position of the body and the front part of the car. So when I will, let's say if I select the car front only, and if I rotate it, Then you can see that it is only rotating the car front because all these are separate layers. So I don't want to change the shadow or the wheels of the car. I want to move the upper part and these characters. So what I can do, I can select all of these layers by pressing Ctrl A, or you can also click on select drop down button and choose select all. And here you can see that it has selected all the layers in the selection pane. So I will unselect those layers that I don't want to move. And for that, let's say I don't want to move these tire and the suspension, the left tire and the right tires. Now you can notice that the shape format has not appeared because we have also selected the audio file. So for that audio file, I will hide it for the time. So I will hide that audio file for the time. Now again, I will select all these layers, Ctrl A, and will uncheck those that I don't want to move. Now I go to the shape format or either picture format and then click on group drop down button and choose group. Now I will rotate this picture as I want. So if you want to rotate it a very particular degree, then what you can do, you can right on click on this picture and choose format picture, and under size and position, go to size or position if you want to change the size. Here under size, you can change the rotation of degree. So let's say I want to rotate it to 2 degrees. Now the next important thing is I have to ungroup all these objects again. As you can see that now they are grouped together under group 4, but I need them as separate layers. So what I will do, I will click on group and then choose ungroup. Even if let's say you have all these layers on the first slide and then you duplicate the slide and change the position of these objects by grouping them. So let's say if I apply the morph transitions, let's see how it will behave. So here you can see that I have applied a very short duration. Instead of applying a duration, I will uncheck it for the time and will make a click on mouse click, and will do the same for the second slide. Now I will show you the slideshow from the first slide. So what I am trying to say that if you want to use the morph transition, even you can use this, but the downside is that if you will group the layers on the next slide and later if you don't ungroup them, then see how morph transition will behave. So let's see the slideshow. Now this is the first slide. If now I click to move on to the next slide, let's see how the morph transition behave. So that is what happened if you change the layers and group them and want to use the morph transition, then you can't do that. So that is why, and morph is also not available in all the versions, so that is why I am not using any animation effect. However, I can also use the spin animation effect and motion path to create the same animation scene, but that will be more complicated than using this trick. So that is why I am using this technique. So on the second slide, after changing the rotation, what you need to do, you have to ungroup the layers again. Now when you will ungroup the layers, then you can notice that the position of layers has changed. Now the right back tire and the right front tire has moved here, whereas they were right here before. So the positioning does matter when you want to create very complicated animations, because let me show you that if I move this body, then you can see that that is the right back tire and that is the suspension of right back tire. So on the very first slide, you have to position all the layers perfectly as you want them. So later you don't have to change the position, and you must also note down that which part was there on the selection pane, on the list of the selection pane, like the right back tire, because you need to do this on each replicated slide again and again. So that is why you must note down the position of each of the layer. So let me undo this for the time. Now we are using the same method on each of the slide. We are duplicating slide again and just changing the position of the objects. As you can see here on the third slide, and if I move again, then you can notice that I have changed the position of the objects. And here you can see the suspension. Now the important thing, the last important thing is that, as you can see here, if I select this one, that is the left back tire, and that is the left back tire suspension. So if you will only see this suspension when the car will move up. So that is why I was telling you that the positioning of the layers should be correct from the very first slide. So you don't have to look onto the all the layers positioning, because we just want to change the position of these tires and these of these characters, and for the rest of the layers we will group all of them and will change the rotation degree. As you can see here, if I open the format picture dialog box for this particular layer here on this 17 number slide, then you can see the rotation here. So I use the same technique on each of the slide by duplicating the same slide again and then changing the position of the layers. And when you do this so many times, like I did this for 33 times, I added another slide here on the second number. Let me delete this. I replicated around 33 times the same slide and changed the position. And finally what I did, I selected all of them from the thumbnail view. Select the first one and press Ctrl A, and in the transition tab make a check mark on after, and here you need to apply the timing, that how much duration you want to give to each of the slides. However, you can also apply different duration to different slides, but we want a continuous scene in the with the same frame in the each second. So I am going to use 0.10 second duration for all of these slides. And finally, if we move up on the top and show you the slideshow, here you have the final animation. So let's say if I change the duration, that it will make the animation faster. Control A, and here I change the duration to 0.05 and hit the enter key, and let's see the slideshow again. Now it's faster than before. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.